Hello and welcome back to the channel. This video is all about the pros and cons of cloud computing. So without further ado, let's get into it. Today, internet is one of the biggest drivers of growth for many businesses. It allows us to advertise these services at a fraction of cost of a TV ads, as well as send the emails and engage with the customers and many more things. Organizations, irrespective of their sizes, are migrating their existing IT infrastructure to their own private cloud or a public cloud or the hybrid cloud, which is a combination of a private and public cloud. It has become an essential part of most businesses. No matter the kind of business you have, a certain cloud type can work for you. There are public, private and hybrid clouds today. Although it had advantages, but it also has some disadvantages. That is what we will be discussing in this video. Now let's talk about the pros first. The first one is no cost of infrastructure. Cloud computing is divided into three major service models. The first one is infrastructure as a service, the second one is a platform as a service, and the third one is a software as a service. In all these categories, one thing is common, that you don't have to invest in any hardware or infrastructure. In general, every organization has to invest in the IT infrastructure, as well as they have to hire a specialized team to manage it. Servers, network devices, storage, and softwares. These are the major things that you need to invest for your IT infrastructure. But if you move to cloud computing, you don't invest in it. You just simply go to the cloud providers and buy the service. It is that convenient, isn't it? Before going forward, if you're liking this video, please consider subscribing and hit the notification bell to get the latest updates. It will really motivate me to create such informative videos for you. The next advantage is reliability. So your infrastructure in cloud will increase the reliability and availability of your cloud services and applications. The next advantage is minimum management and cost. By selecting the cloud services, you save the cost in many ways. The first one is zero investment in the infrastructure. The next one is, since you are not owning the infrastructure, you don't have to worry about managing it, or you don't need to hire a dedicated staff to manage your infrastructure. And the third one is, cloud works on the pay-as-you-go model. So you will only pay for the resources that you need, nothing more. Which means if you opt for the cloud, the infrastructure cost and the maintenance cost is the sole responsibility of the cloud provider and not the cloud users. The next advantage is data backup and recovery. Loss of data can significantly impact your business. So if you lose any critical information, that it will cost you a sum of money. It will waste your time and it will adversely impact your brand image. To prevent it, you can automatically backup all the data on the cloud on the regular basis. This will help you recover your data in case of accidental deletions, as well as some natural disasters or the hardware crashes. The next advantage is huge cloud storage. Most cloud services will provide you a free, secure and huge amount of storage to store all your valuable information. Although many cloud storage providers such as OneDrive can provide you a huge storage on free of cost, but if you use it all, you can also opt for more storage by purchasing their subscriptions and store your data in the cloud. The next advantage is automatic software updates. So updating softwares every now and then can become a frustrating task for many enterprises. The IT department needs to update the system for every individual, which not only wastes your time, but also the productivity. So you can opt for automatic update service from the cloud providers to save your valuable time. The next advantage is you should forget about the administrative and management hassles. So whenever there is a purchase or upgradation of the hardware, it takes a very long procedure to establish the infrastructure. So this process includes a lot of administrative or management tasks which can waste a lot of time. But if you go for cloud services, you just need to compare the cloud vendors, their different plans, and you can choose whatever the plan which fits your requirements. And this whole process doesn't take much time, and it will save you a lot of efforts. After discussing many advantages of cloud services, now let's discuss the disadvantages of cloud computing. The first one is it is reliant on the internet connectivity. So running your business on the cloud has many advantages as long as you have the good internet connectivity. When your cloud service providers will lose the internet connectivity, your whole business will suddenly stop. Even the best cloud providers may experience the downtimes. In that case, no transactions will take place if your business is highly reliant on the cloud. The next disadvantage is there is an issue of security. The cloud is not for every business. Some data is too sensitive to be placed on cloud. So when you place company's data on the cloud, you are trusting the third party for the security of the data. So that data will be subjected to a standard data protection measures that the third party vendors will offer to all their clients. So it makes it difficult to trust those third parties to protect your data. The next disadvantage is limited control. So whenever the company stores data on the cloud, they may have the limited control over that data. A customer can only control and manage the front end of the application. The cloud service providers are responsible for all the back-end activities, so you don't get to access the different operations which are running on the back-end and the risk that your data may be exposed to. And the last one is inflexible contracts. Most cloud providers have inflexible contracts, which makes it more challenging for the business who is continuously growing and changing. If you're thinking for cloud migration, you will need to know that it has their own pros and cons. Conduct your research before you decide to settle on any option. It will help you to save a lot of money over time. So to wrap this up, sure, there are some pros and cons to the cloud computing. Analyzing them would determine whether it's good for your business or not. No doubts, with the time, the industry leaders will manage to reduce the cons. There is an ongoing process of reducing the cost and improving the cloud services in the cloud market. But still, there is no correct answer to the question whether you should opt for the cloud computing or you should wait for some time. But it continues to conquer the market.